Once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you. Once again. Once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you. Once again. Steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. New every morning.
Oh,
despised. You were rejected, Lord. Those who passed by even averted their gaze from the sight. Such was the suffering you bore for us. Led like a lamb to the slaughter, you spoke not a word, but chose to be silent, though you did no wrong, nor was deceitfulness found in you. Yet by your our salvation has come, yet by your suffering our freedom is won. Yet by your wounds our salvation has come, yet by your suffering our freedom is won. For God
God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, and what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe. Bless your name, Abba Father. We love you. We love your Son. We love the Holy Spirit. We give you our affections this Monday morning. We love partnering with you. Thank you for inviting us into partnership with your heart. Oh, we invite the Holy Spirit to be our guide today, this week. Lead us into all truth. Holy Spirit, take the things that belong to God and make them known.
Strengthen our hearts by your love.
eyes of our hearts.
Open our eyes that we might see you right.
Conversations, God, that exalt you. We want to declare the love of God to people that you will bring our way this week. We want to see your kingdom advanced in our sphere of influence. We love partnering with you. We look forward to all that you will direct us into this week, God. It is our desire that your name would be exalted through our lives this week. In our 9-to-5, that the name of Jesus would be exalted. When we go home, that the name of Jesus would be exalted. When we encounter our neighbors, people at the grocery store and the restaurants, that your name would be exalted. God, we ask you to come and let your anointing rest upon your sons and daughters in the workplace this week, that each one would feel your presence, each one would feel the Holy Spirit on the inside, alive unto God, joyful in the place of partnership with you, that a fragrance of Jesus would arise from every workplace, wherever men and women call upon the name of the Lord, in every workplace, that a fragrance of worship would arise, that incense would arise. As we labor before your eyes, God. Receive our work today, our labor today, as our worship, as our way of loving you. Come, strengthen the hearts of men and women in the workplace.
A work of opportunity to minister to anyone joining us who has an assignment in the workplace. Whether you have a job or you're looking for a job, we want to take some time and pray for you. So I want to invite you to stand up and step out in the aisles so we can gather around you. So I want to invite the rest of the room. Let's gather around these ones. I encourage you to introduce yourself to them and ask them their name and how you can be agreeing with them in prayer. But right now, as we lay hands on our brothers and sisters this morning, we just take this opportunity to celebrate them, celebrate the assignment, God, that you've given them to be bearers of your light, bearers of your glory, to take the name of Jesus out into the city. But we thank you for the fragrance of your name, the fragrance of your presence, God, that goes with them this morning. We thank you, Lord, as we celebrate Pentecost Sunday this last weekend, Lord, that they have the Spirit of Christ living on the inside this morning. Holy Spirit, we invite you, come and do what you love to do. Speak to your children. Speak to your sons and daughters. Tell them more of who they are to you. Tell them more of what you think when you look at them, of what you think about the assignment you've given them, God. Speak to them this morning. Lord, as we come alongside them and lay hands on them, we ask you, release your spirit of prophecy to encourage them right now in the name of Jesus.
Let
joining with men and women all across the globe today from every sphere of society, praying for one another from 1 Corinthians 1, 5 through 8, that you are enriched in everything by him in all utterance and all knowledge, even as the testimony of Christ is confirmed in you, so that you come short in no gift, eagerly waiting for the revelation of Jesus Christ, who will also confirm you to the end, that you may be blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, Lord, we come today thanking you that you have enriched us with everything we need for this day and for this week. We love your assignments. We love you and that you have placed us in specific jobs, some as nannies, some as engineers, some as doctors, some as financiers. Lord, all of us are looking for you this week that we might please you and bless you and work with you, God. So, Lord Jesus, I thank you for this beautiful reminder in Scripture where you speak to us about the fact that we'll be availed everything that is needed. Lord, this goes from the words that we need to speak, whether it be on a one-on-one conversation, whether it be in a meeting, whether it be making a proposal, whether it be a live conversation or a virtual conversation or an email conversation, that, Lord, you bless our utterance. You bless our mouth. You bless our fingers as we type the email, as we send the message, God, that we would today be ambassadors of your great light. I ask that in the most mundane task, that the way we carry it out would just bring the very fragrance of Christ into a room, into an institution, into a building, into a circle, Lord. That no job is beneath your radar today. Lord, you have placed janitors divinely today. You have placed CEOs supernaturally today. You have your people on their post. And Lord, we want to wake up and know that you placed us here. We want to embrace you, God. We ask that the word of wisdom be upon our tongue and be upon our keyboards, that our communication today will just by the very tone, just the very tone, just a kind tone, bring you into the room, Lord. So we thank you for this. We want to be alert to it. We want to be alert how we say things, how we speak solutions, how we are not the ones belaboring the problem, Lord. We are, in fact, the ones that are bringing solutions. So speak to us and speak through us this day with it, God, with the very utterance upon our tongue. Lord, we love that you give us a prophetic revelation, just that little knowing in our spirit of what's going on. We love the way you give us a tip-off to know how to avert a crisis, how to bring peace, how to be the man of peace in a meeting, the woman of peace in a meeting. And Lord, we ask that our Holy Spirits would be attuned, that you, Holy Spirit, would tune our spirits just so that we're communing with you, hearing from you, God. Are listening to that still small voice as you guide us, just shifting a little to the left, a little to the right, and that this is our great hope, that we are able to work all day long without losing communication with you, God. There are no dead spots with the Holy Spirit. So we thank you for utterance on our tongue, prophetic revelation in our spirit that brings forth everything we need today to do the work as unto you. Lord, we love this type of partnership where you are our active partner. You are not in the back room. You're not just a secret investor. You're not just someone who hands over a script, but you are actually with us through the day. And that we might stay in that place of sweet communion, meeting by meeting, hour by hour, project by project, whatever it is that you've called us to do. Lord, fill us with your Holy Spirit anew this morning. Issues or problems that we know we are about to face. Lord, replace that anxiety with just the peace of God. The very peace of God. The very right word. The very specific time. The very wise counsel of God. So Lord, we love the way you work with us, and we accept your invitation today to speak with you, to speak for you, to move in your timing, to bring the presence of God into our very workplaces. So show us how this works today. Teach us this dance, this holy dance today, that we might feel your presence, your very breath upon our lives, from the moment we clock in till the moment we actually lay our heads on the pillow tonight. Thank you that this is how you work with us in all of life, God. So speak now to us. Reveal your wisdom to us. Download some strategies specific for this day and for this week. This is our prayer, God. So speak to us now. In the name of Jesus, we're poised and we listen. So speak, Father. Testify. Lord, So God, confirm your testimony in us this day. We offer ourselves to you, God, for you to write upon our hearts and bring forth the testimony, confirming it, God, with signs, with wonders, with the peace and presence of our Lord Jesus Christ. So Lord, confirm your testimony in us. In Jesus' name we ask this and agree with you. Amen.
pray that you would just strengthen your children with your love, God, that you would give them confidence and love in the marketplace, knowing that you are working behind the scenes, knowing that you are working for them. Father, I pray that you would release grace to walk in the Spirit, God, to abide in your love, to stay wrapped up in your peace, no matter what the circumstances are going on around them. I ask that you would just keep them seated in that place of divine love and divine encounter, God, and that you would just come in and that you would release that confidence through them to love the people around them and to extend your kingdom in the marketplace.
God, you're the one that brings forth that river in the midst. midst of a desert. You could hear the God of the trump card this morning to trump those areas that seem difficult. We see that Genesis 18 in the midst of our work today. God, is anything too difficult for you? God, we know nothing is. So we declare, God, that we'll watch with that childlike hope, that awe and wonder today. God, how you love to trump those. Declare today, we're not going to settle for just a small thinking, but God, we stretch. We come with that expectation, that childlike hope, that carefree hope this morning. God, anything's possible in you. As we say this morning, God, release your hope. Fill us today with joy and peace. Fill us today with that abounding hope in the midst of the marketplace.
Great skill and wisdom and grace
as we build this gospel net to cast across the city. Lord, we ask you to raise up laborers. Lord, we ask you for people that will canvas our city, go to every single home in this city and invite them to this outreach. Lord, we ask you to raise up evangelists to work at this outreach, people to set up, people to tear down and clean up. Lord, we ask you to move your servants for this great harvest. And Father, we ask you that this Saturday, as your servants cast this net across the city of Grandview, Lord, we ask you to fill this net. Lord, fill this net with the poor and the suffering and the brokenhearted and the oppressed. Lord, we ask that the power of your gospel will go forth from the lips of your servants at this outreach, that bondages will be broken, that hearts will turn to you. Lord, we ask you that there will be healings. We ask you for marriages to be restored, for the hearts of the fathers to turn to the sons and the sons to the fathers. Holy Father, we ask you that in this outreach, that as we lift up Jesus, that Jesus will be lifted up and you will draw all of Grandview to you. Lord, we want to ask you for good weather for this outreach, that there will be favorable winds, that there'll be favorable temperatures, there'll be no rain. Lord, we ask you to protect your servants as they labor this week. Keep your servants from physical assault, spiritual, family, financial problems. Lord, we want to ask you for profound conversions at this outreach. We ask you that people will come and that old things will pass away and all things will become new. Lord, we ask you that every single one that is in this net will be baptized in water and in your Holy Spirit, will be rooted and grounded and established. And Lord, we ask you that these same people will be joining next year and serving to bring this city to you. Lord, we ask you now that this outreach will be a vital part of this great mosaic that is coming together to bring this parade from Grandview to the stadiums. Lord, we ask you now that the people in that parade, some of them will be those who are healed at this outreach. So Lord, we ask you now in the name of Jesus, and we proclaim over this city that Jesus is Lord of Grandview. We ask you now for your face shine upon this outreach. May your favor be upon it, and may your kingdom come in Grandview. In Jesus' name.
Father, magnify your step down into darkness. Oh,